Okay, so today you want to go for a bike ride. Well, the Dover Newfane Loop in the Dover Wilmington region of southern Vermont is one of the most difficult, beautiful, and rewarding bike rides that there is. You start in the town of West Dover at about 1,700 feet and you head north up Route 100. You'll pass Mount Snow to your west and you'll begin a steady incline to 2,400 feet. From the top of this ridge, Route 100 is going to drop about 2,000 feet over the course of the next 15 miles. This stretch is incredibly windy, narrow, and dangerous. Do not ride this loop if this is your first time on narrow mountain trails. You must be extremely comfortable on how to share the road and go around blind corners in order to take this loop. You can reach speeds in excess of 50 to 60 miles an hour as you head down this side of the hill. You're going to come down through the town of Wardsboro, and eventually you'll come to the intersection of Route 100 North and Route 30 South. This is about 17 miles into the ride. Up until this point, there really isn't any place to stop and grab anything to eat or drink, so take everything with you that you'll need from the start. Once you get to the intersection of Route 100 and 30, you're going to take the right onto Route 30 South towards West Townsend and Townsend. After you pass through Townsend, you'll come into Newfane. This is a great place to rest, grab some water, grab something to eat. This is about the halfway point of the ride. It's also the low point. Here you'll be only about 400 feet above sea level. Once you leave Newfane, you're going to continue on Route 30 South and you're going to start your climb back up to the 1,700 feet that you started at. From Route 30 South, you're looking for the right-hand turn onto Grimes Hill Road. Do not miss the turn onto Grimes Hill. If you do, you'll end up in Brattleboro, and there's really no way to ride back to West Dover. Once you make the right turn onto Grimes Hill will turn into Dover Road. Once you're on Dover Road, the climb begins. Dover Hill is in front of you. It starts off pretty steady, and then it gets intense. It climbs nearly 1,000 feet in about half a mile. Just when you think it can't get any steeper, then it really starts to climb on you. From the top of Dover Hill, you're going to have beautiful views of southern Vermont in all directions. And the best part is you get to enjoy a nice coast back down into the town of West Dover to finish the ride. This is a beautiful but difficult ride. Good luck!